Hello explorers, and welcome back to another Java video. And today I'm going to talk a little bit more about TensorFlow, Windows, and Java. And last video I said that for the moment running Java on Windows or building TensorFlow on Windows should not even be considered because there were too many hurdles and you weren't able to actually create something in Windows. And that was pretty much because of the Bazel version that was out then, 0.4.4, didn't work in Windows and didn't build a new version of Bazel. So there were a lot of hurt there. They have actually been a release of Bazel in the middle of March, where they released 0.4.5, and this version is actually able to build Bazel with the same structure that I tried out earlier. Just works and you get a Bazel install that you can later use with TensorFlow. But you need to download Bazel, the binary, in order to build Bazel. So I'm not sure if that helps us, really, because we want the new version of Bazel, and the new version of Bazel is the one that is out. When it comes to building TensorFlow from source, I was able to actually build TensorFlow from source, and everything went fine with GPU support and everything. The sad part is that when TensorFlow has built from source, you should create a pip package to install it on your system. And that pip package is built from an output directory where the build source will be put. And that build directory is empty. So the pip package becomes pretty sparse. I added the things that it was looking for into this build directory, and it was able to build the pip package and install the pip package. Sadly, the bindings between the DLLs and the library was not sufficient to run and actually train the data. But the version of TensorFlow 1.0.1 is actually out as a pip package now, so you can install that directly from the repository online, and that will actually have this save module function that we were using in Java. So you can run with that and train your model with GPU support, and I ran it for a couple of minutes and I got a result of 99.15, which is a little bit worse than the first time I ran it, but it can differ a little bit. So I don't think that it is actually because of the installation. It could be something else. And the Java bindings, where I was actually able to build those from source without any hiccups, without any problems. The only thing there was that you needed to change the name of them. So we can go over here to my little work log here. Everything in this work log is up on GitHub, so you can read it there. And here under experimental, I've put some of the documentation of what I've done. I will flush this out even more, but here I have all the things needed to set in order to run and install compile Bazel. And then I checked out TensorFlow revision 1.1 and download NumPy, set some variables, configured it with a lot of parameters. I think in my case I only need the feature 6.1 because that's what my computer graphics card is actually supporting, but your miles may vary. So 5.2 and 6.1, then you actually cover most of the newest cards, so that could be a good way. But there is actually a page where you can look this up. I will put that into this tutorial as well. And then you just build this pip packager, which will create your pip package for you. And these, I found out, these build options are quite interesting, that you actually need to set your architecture, your CPU and host CPU in order for it to build. So these build options are required to build this package in Windows, and that I found in one of the issues on GitHub. So I think there might be some more issues before you get a smooth build of TensorFlow. But then again, if you have a package already working, then you don't really need to build it by your own. But I wanted to try it out. And this is how you later build the pip package. And this is the command that didn't work for me. And here we have how to build the GNI Java bindings. And the thing to note there is it will actually create a lib TensorFlow underscore JNI DLL OSO, and you need to change the name of that to TensorFlow underscore JNI dot DLL in order and put that in your JNI map in order for TensorFlow to pick it up and actually get it working. So if you build your JNI files by your own, then don't forget to change the name of your JNI bindings DLL to the new name. And then you also get the jar file that you need to install into your Maven in order to get that working. And I have the instructions how to do that in the Linux tutorial. So those are not different from the Windows tutorial. And I think everything when it comes to building the JNI is not different from the Linux tutorial. So then I've talked about everything. Now I just had to run it in Windows and see that my own built Java bindings worked. And I actually got the result of 99.15, which is the same result as I got inside of TensorFlow Python bindings when I trained the network. So I'm quite happy that even though I'm running on my own build, so this is 1.1.0RC1, which is that revision that I built. I'm quite happy that I can build my own Java bindings, get those to work. Sadly, the Java bindings do not support GPUs at the moment, so it will be a bit slower, but I still think if you just use these to verify or use these to actually find results or predictions, I think they are fast enough. So yeah, that was my Java update on how to build TensorFlow on Windows. Last time it was not possible to do, and much has changed since last time I talked about this. I hope that you found this information hopeful and interesting, and please leave me a comment if you try to run TensorFlow for your own on Windows and what your result was. And if you have tried to build it on Windows, please give me a hint on how to do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.